When printers stop working, the damage is already done and productivity is impacted. On-site staff may not have the knowledge to resolve issues in a timely manner. Did you know that you could leverage SOTI Connect to manage and secure your organization's printers to ensure that they're operating at a peak performance with maximum uptime? Hey, how's it going? My name is Mario and I'm a sales engineering manager here at SOTI. Welcome to a SOTI How-To Series. This episode is a first of a three-part series where we will show you how to enroll Zebra printers into SOTI Connect. In this video, you will learn how to generate the root and server certificates for use on an MQTT server. Then in a following video, we will learn how to set up and register the MQTT server on SOTI Connect. Finally, we will learn how to enroll Zebra printers into SOTI Connect. So, let's get to it. Depending on the customer and their policies, root and server certificates may need to be obtained from the customer and signed by the preferred certificate authority. For this video, however, we will use generated self-signed certificates using our own private certificate authority. We can generate self-signed certificates in several different ways, including OpenSSL PowerShell scripts or tools such as XCA. In this case, we'll be using XCA. Before we generate MQTT root and server certificates, we must mention a few technical requirements first. We will need the XCA certificate and management tool to generate certificates and securely store them. Also, we will need the Portical app to create the Java key store. Now that we're all set, let's start configuring. First things first, you're gonna need to download the XCA tool. We can download the XCA tool from the developer's website on GitHub. You can download Portical app from portical.sourceforge.net. Second, once the XCA app is installed, we will need to create a new database and choose a secure password and location for it. Click the Import tab and import templates if you have any. We will import templates for the root and server certificates in which fields such as country, company, common name, validity period, and other fields are pre-populated. Third, we will generate a root certificate using the root certificate template with a private key of an appropriated size. Then verify the certificate's validity period and other fields. Click the Generate a New Certificate button, select your key size, and click Create. You will receive a notification for successfully creating an RSA private key. Click OK. Now we're going to generate a server certificate. Click Generate New Certificate. Sign it with the root certificate previously generated using the server templates with a private key of an appropriated key size. Also, verify the common name of the subject alternative name, matching the server where the certificate will be used and any other fields for the certificate. Click OK and we will receive notification that we've successfully created a server certificate. We can also verify that in the drop-down menu in the main XCA certificate app window. Next, we will export the server certificate in a PFX format. Type and verify your password here and save the certificate file. This PFX file will then be added to a Java key store for use with inside of the MQTT server. The root certificate will be exported in a PEM format and will be used by the MQTT NRD. The Zebra MQTT notifier will apply the required MQTT settings and certificates onto the printer. I will now run Portical from the command prompt window that will create the Java key store for the MQTT server. Click the file menu and add the new key store command in the Portical app. Now we're going to save the Java key store as a JKS. Set the key store password and note it for use with the MQTT server. Save the file in an appropriate folder such as JKS file and click OK. As we can see, the server certificate is in a key pair format and now can be imported. Enter your previously noted key store password and click OK. Using the certificate details command, we can verify dates and extensions. You can set an alias here if you like. We can now set the private key entry password. Please note it for later as we'll be using it with the MQTT server. We'll receive a notification for the successful importation of the key pair. The certificate and Java key store are now ready. We can now set up the MQTT server. I'll explain this process in the next video. And that's it. In just a few minutes, we learned how to generate an MQTT root and server certificate for your Zebra printers and harness the power of SOTI Connect to keep your business critical Zebra printers operational. Whether they're across town or around the world, it really, really doesn't matter. We're here to support you. Thank you very much for tuning in. If you find our content valuable, subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Now, with that being said, to learn more about how the SOTI One platform makes mobile first business operations simple and efficient and reliable, visit us at SOTI.net, and I'll see you there.